Scripture is printed in the bulletin every week.
Yes.
So you ain't got to wait for pastor to,
right,
to get up and tell you the scripture. It's already there. And y'all can turn to it when you first get to your seats.
Amen.
Amen. Just for you, mama. Just for you. Amen. Amen. As reading starting at the 11th verse, it says, as Jesus continued towards Jerusalem, he reached the border between Galilee and Samaria. As he entered the village there, 10 men with leprosy stood at a distance, crying out, Jesus, Master, have mercy on me. He looked at them and said to them, go show yourself to the priest. As they went, they were cleansed of their leprosy. He didn't touch them. He didn't sprinkle the oil on them. He by them said, come and buy this holy water, you will be healed with the holy water. He just said, go, serve yourself to the priest. And as they went, they were cleansed of their leprosy. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, he came back shouting, praise God. He fell to the ground at Jesus' feet, thanking him for what he had done. This man was a Samaritan. Jesus' acts did not heal 10 men, where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give glory to God except for this foreigner? And Jesus said to the man, stand up, go, your faith has healed you. We're going to take for a title or a subject on this morning, are you the one? Are you the one? Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this time and this moment and this space to be able to preach and proclaim your word. But God, we ask you to remove me yourself and fill me well with your anointing and your
thank
Holy
you,
Spirit. Hide me behind your sacred cross that the people see out of me
please,
and all of thee. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. There's a traditional and almost embarrassed prayer of thanks that many of us offer at Thanksgiving because we are not accustomed to the gratitude as a habit. And it is foreign in our daily routine to give God thanks. We become too much like the 9 lepers who, unlike the lone one, was grateful Samaritan and he returned to thank Jesus for healing him. We take God's blessing as our due reward. We have succumbed to an entitlement mindset. And if we read that full story over and over again, we can put ourselves a lot of times in the mindset of the 9 that just went to show themselves to the priest. See, Thanksgiving is what we really should be doing every single day.
Amen.
All year long.
Yes.
But why don't we do it? Because we become entitled like many of our young people. We have an expectation of God just doing what God does without giving him the thanks that's due his name. We expect to wake up every morning. We expect our cars to start. We expect to get to work without no hassle or not having an accident. We expect that when we get to our jobs, our desks, it's just like we left them. We have an expectation and not a gratitude of thanking God for waking us up in the morning. We don't give thanks for allowing our cars to start. And we know it's cold, getting colder now, and sometimes your car don't want to act right. Amen.
Amen.
And then we expect to make it to work safe and sound. But as we look at the news every single morning, there's an accident on 95.
Yeah.
There's an accident waiting to happen on 195. And you are just good. God just protected you good enough to be able to get from one destination.
Amen.
To the next. Many of us got in our vehicles on this morning expecting to get to church on time, but we didn't give God thanks when we got here. We didn't give God thanks when we shut off our car. We didn't give God thanks that somebody made it so that the church would be warm when we get here. We just expected it, and it happened. Moses described this in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 11 and 14, when he reminded them that the Lord had cared for them in the desert, placed them and provided them for protection while they was going through all they had to go through. But the children of Israel got to a point where they stopped thanking God and started wanting to thank themselves. That's why they built the idol. That's why they built certain things. They didn't believe that the 40 years in the wilderness was actually something to thank God for. Because most of us don't like our wilderness experience. We think our wilderness experience is all just about heartache and pain. Your wilderness experience is there for you to be able to get a one-on-one relationship with Christ, a one-on-one relationship with God, to be able to thank him for the protection in the wilderness. Many of us should be in mental hospitals of the wilderness that we have been through, but God has brought you out, and you don't even look like what you've been through, and that's something to give thanks for anyway. Many of us had more bills than we had money, but the light stayed on. That's something to give thanks for. Many of us water should have been cut off, but then the water company didn't see you last week. That's something to give thanks for. Many of us have piles of trash on the outside because you ain't paid county waste until last week. And when they still kept picking your trash up, that's something to give thanks God for. Many of us, our children should be dead or in jail somewhere, but thanks be unto God, they still here with us, that's something to give thanks for.
Amen.
But if the children of Israel, they had this one-on-one personal relationship with Christ or with God, if they can mess up, so can we.
Amen.
The children wanted some things that they needed some things from God. We have to really guard ourselves against ingratitude.
Yeah.
We have to guard ourselves, and we have to remember God and thank God for His deliverance in the past.
Yeah. Amen.
Glory.
Glory.
We have to thank God and give thanks to God for His benefits in the present.
Yeah. Glory.
And we have to thank and give God praise for His promises for the future.
Yes.
Deliverance from the past, because all of us have a past.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Some of y'all might be more embarrassed of your past than other folk is. But you have a past.
Yes.
And if you didn't have a past, you wouldn't be here in the present.
Come on.
You wouldn't be able to shout. You wouldn't be able to give God thanks for your past if He didn't let you die in your own foolishness.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Lord.
Because many of us, like I said before, should be at Oakwood Cemetery somewhere.
Come on now.
But then we got some benefits that we look past right now.
Uh-huh.
Thanks be unto God, when we look in our closets, we have choices.
Amen.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thanks be unto God that when we wake our children up, they still wake up.
Amen.
Thanks be unto God that when we nudge or hit our husbands or wives in the middle of the night, they still have sense enough to move over.
Amen.
All right, then you step
up. And if they don't move over, you just snuggle right on up beside them and take your hat box right back to sleep anyway. And some of y'all just touching just to be making sure they still there. We ain't talking about falling off the bed. We ain't talking about that. You went to go to break something in your nightstand, you ended up in the floor calling for prayer and stuff. We ain't talking about that. But thanks be unto God, no matter how old you are, how young you are, there is a future in God. There is a future that God has for you, because if you didn't have any future, you wouldn't be here today.
Amen.
And too many of us are riddled with anxiety because we can't figure out what our future is when God has already written our future, and we angry, upset, and can't give God thanks for where He got us right now, for we can be able and be better in the future.
Amen.
If we forget God is in any of these areas, ingratitude will slip in, leading us to miss our blessings and miss opportunities for growth. His deliverance in the past, like Prophet Hosea said, God is having a perspective on Israel's forgiveness. In Hosea 13:4-6, he said, he detailed the terrible consequences of forgetting and being and having ingratitude. After coming through this period of a drought and arriving at a point of satisfaction in our lives, it is easy for us to become like the Israelites. Many of us get satisfied and don't want to do anything. When God has supplied all your needs and you are satisfied with God, it's therefore an opportunity for you to grow a little bit further.
Yes, yes.
And too many of us are stunting our own growth because we are satisfied exactly where we are. See, here it is now, our growth. If a plant stops growing, it's dead. If it's dead, you pull it up and throw it away. So, and likewise, if you stop growing, you dead. And there's way too many dead folk in the church and wonder why there's no deliverance, because a lot of folk have stopped growing. When you start growing and you keep growing, you produce what? Fruit. Don't nobody want to plant a plant and it ain't producing no fruit. It don't even. What's the fruit of a rose bush? A nice, pretty rose. And every year you looking at this rose bush just sit there and do nothing, eventually you're going to get tired of looking at this bush. And you're going to pluck it up and throw it in the trash. And then it's gone. Many of us are just sitting there and are not getting the nutrients from God. And that's why we can't grow and we are dying, because our attitude is jacked up.
Yeah. All right.
That's right.
Because we can't see God in everything. Because we can't find a reason to say thank you, Lord, for being able to wake us up this morning. We can't find a reason to, when we look at our cereal closet, we have two or three different types of cereal. Children, when you get free lunch, reduced lunch, or some your parents pay for your lunch, you have choices in the cafeteria.
Yeah.
And that's a thankful moment when you can even decide that I'm gonna give me a pop top, I'm gonna give me some frosted flake, or I'm gonna get something hot from in the morning from the cafeteria. Mm-hmm. Y'all forget to give thanks for that.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't miss many meals in school. I ain't miss none at home either. But one of my favorite meals in school, and most folk ain't get it, most folk couldn't, was the meatloaf, the cabbage, and the hot rolls. And then they had the nerve to put some potatoes and some gravy on the side. So we had people, grandmamas in our school cafeteria, and we had to look. I don't know what y'all got there in y'all school cafeteria. But when I knew Miss Cosby was in the back and the meatloaf was right, it had some onions in it, it had some green peppers in it, it had a little ketchup on the top. And then they had homemade rolls in the school cafeteria. I said my prayer and I gave thanks. Because I ain't have to eat that pizza on that day. But isn't it a shame how the best food in our cafeteria is a slice of pizza? Because we have not treated the people outside of the teachers with the respect and the dignity that takes care of our kids.
Amen.
The bus drivers don't get respected. The cafeteria workers don't get respected. The teachers don't get respected. But at least they get a little bit more pay. Amen. We have to believe in His presence. His presence. Because when we're in the present time and day, we have to be able to give thanks for the people that we got around us.
Amen.
And if the people that are around you ain't doing you no good, you need to change your people. Because too many of us are staying around folk that don't care about us. And then we get mad and angry at the world, but you can decide to leave. But I ain't gonna have no friends, don't worry about it. God gonna make a way for you to have somebody that love you. But you gotta get away from the folk that's pulling you down. You gotta get away from folk that's cursing you with cursing. You gotta get away from the people that don't even believe in the same God you believe in.
Yeah,
yeah. That's
for
sure.
You gotta, and then you have to have promises for your future. You gotta give Him thanks for your future. Just because you're going through right now don't mean you ain't no future. Just because the children of Israel was in the valley or in the wilderness for 40 years, it didn't say they stayed in the wilderness forever. They just had a time period because, number one, they was disobedient. Mm-hmm. When you are disobedient to God, you have to go through some things. When you're disobedient from your parents, guess what? You go through some things. We have to have these, and I begin to look at this scripture, I begin to look at this text, and I always have to find the point of the text. I always have to find these things in the text. The text, in one of the verses, it says, the one man, Jesus said, go and show yourselves to the priests. Mm-hmm. And as they went, they became clean. Mm-hmm. But this is the one that got me. One of them, verse 15, highlight that. Look at this later. Mm-hmm. One of them looked at himself. One of them saw that he was healed. Yeah. See, a lot of folk that suffered from leprosy back in the day, they could not look up. They would walk around with their head down. Number one, that's a mistake. Don't ever walk, I don't care what you have been through, I don't care what you're going through, always walk with your head up. When you walk with your head down, you think that's a form of shame. And Jesus, the word said, if you are in Christ, there is no condemnation.
Amen.
So you always have to walk with your head up. I don't care if you failed the test, walk with your head up. I don't care if he left you, walk with your head up. I don't care if she took all the money out of the bank, walk with your head up. Because when you walk with your head up, can't nobody tell what you're going through. So here it is, this one man, this one person looked at himself. And sometimes you gotta look at yourself and see God's glory.
All right, all right.
Cause ain't nobody gonna love you like you. And if you don't love you, how can anybody else love you? I remember this one football player, T.O. Terrell Owens, he said, I love me some me. And I thought, this is the most arrogant thing you can say. That just put me off. Then I remembered this. God made, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. God has chosen. I don't look like nobody. There's some folks that look similar to me, but don't nobody look exactly like me. Can't nobody act exactly like me. Even if you have my DNA in you, you still don't look exactly, work exactly, walk exactly, talk exactly, have the mindset exactly like me. And if God put it in me, I should admire it. Too many of us don't admire the goodness of God. That's why we can't find the opportunity to give God thanks. Because if you look at yourself in the mirror, put your clothes on, and you can put on the song, I look good, I look fly, oh my mama. See, some of y'all don't even know that song, and some of y'all might need to get that song when you put on your clothes in the morning, because it's going to make for a better day. It's going to make you look better than what you might actually look. But guess what? If it's me, I'm just looking like God made me look. And so now I can give thanks for God for designing me, for purposing me, for giving me something that the way I look, I might not be as skinny and as tight as I want to be, but I look just like me, and I'm good. Pass the holes in the back, had to look in the mirror and say, I wonder who that guy looked like. Oh, that's me, and I'm all right. I said, who you want to be? No, I just want to be me. See, too many of y'all don't want to be somebody else and not want to be you, and that's why you find out all other troubles in your life, because you don't look like you want to look. So this one guy, this one person, this one leper looked at himself. The others did not look at themselves. That's why they couldn't give God thanks. Too many of us are ashamed of yourself. Are you the one? This one, he looked at himself and he said he is whole. Then this dude runs back. It was 10 of them. It was 10 of them. One of them looked. Stop looking at stuff that ain't meant for you. One of them looked. And he said leprosy was a skin disease. Leprosy was contagious. God, Jesus didn't have to touch him. He just said, go. And they didn't complain. They didn't say, oh, he's supposed to have touched us. He's supposed to have did this. That's not the way you get blessed. See, too many of us have an expectation on how to get blessed and not believing in the faith of God. If God tell you to go somewhere, you just go. But see, these 10 were obedient to go to the priest, the place that they can get confirmation on their healing. And one of them looked. And he looked. And he had to go back because he looked. And he was different.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Sometimes you gotta take an old picture and look at a new picture and believe that you are different than what you was in the past.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Go look at a yearbook.
Oh, yeah.
And if you look like you look right now in your yearbook from 50 years ago, but guess what? You can look at that person in your yearbook and say, this was a fool.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, sir.
This person was crazy.
Hallelujah.
This person won't even in their own right now. I thank be unto God that God protected me, that this person can turn out to be this person. I thank be unto God that what I was doing back then, I ain't doing now, that God came enough about me to love me, to give me a proper great hand. God loved me enough that this fine individual right here turned into this mature individual right here, that I can handle all the things that God has still given me and still blessing me with, even though my hair ain't as flowing as it used to be, but some of us ain't even got no hair, thank you, Lord. Y'all remember how I used to have dreads and all that stuff, but they gone now. I thought I was fly back then, but you can't tell me nothing right now. Because I look different, I smell different, I walk different, I talk different. So I got a different approach to things. Things that used to get on my nerves back then can't get on my nerves now. Because God has blessed me enough to be able to look in the mirror and say, God, the things can't change me because I am a new creature in you. He said, all the things in the past are dead, but behold, I have become new. And too many of us looking at our gray hair and thinking ain't no newness coming. The newness is that you got enough wisdom that your hair ain't gray. You ain't got the color in you, you ain't got the dye, you ain't got the fragile, let it flow. Because guess what? That means you got something that God that took you through, and you got something that God you can thank God for. They used to be with it just for men. They used to put that thing in their gear because they didn't want that stuff. They didn't want that gray ass showing. Look, now it's sexy to have a salt and pepper beard.
That's Jesus.
I got a full strength. And one time I was telling the barber to trim the things up, and somebody told me it looked cute, so I'm like, I'm gonna save me with a mustache and just wait to come on in. I have two right here and two right there. I look different because I am different because God has gifted me some stuff so I can thank God for what He's already taken me through, to be able to praise God when I'm going through, to be able to get the blessings of God in my future. Somebody once said this, that when it's bad and bad, it's gonna be better, bad and bad. I don't care when bad and bad, there's no bad and bad coming. I ain't really trying to rush bad and bad because bad and bad gonna be there. See, here it is now. Jesus could have complained about coming through 40 and two generations. He could have complained about being born in a manger. He could have complained about having all these folk coming here, wearing him half to death, when he was trying to take a nap on the boat, and they all crying and whining and didn't even know who he really was. Because if they knew who he really was, they knew they couldn't die on this here boat that was gonna make it over. But see, sometimes you got folk around you that don't know who you really are and start whining and complaining in your presence. And all you gotta do is tell them peace. Be still. So folk in your life, you need to tell them to peace, be still. Because now here, Medea said she wanted to get her a piece of steel. Because I don't carry my pieces of steel around me because I know my attitude ain't right all the time. And y'all will be bailing the pastor out of jail down 17th Street and the wrong person cut him off in traffic. And so I just have to start talking to stuff. I have to start speaking to things. I have to start being able to say, look at myself in the mirror and understand that I look different. And since I look different, I can go give God thanks. I can go give God praise. Are you the one that can turn away from your friends and give God praise? These old ones had recognized the power of God in their life. These old ones couldn't recognize the healing, but they walked around with their head down. But one walked around with his head down, looked at his hands, and his hands looked through. Looked at his feet, and they hear the truth. These old ones realized and understand who the master was. They called master from afar. But when the master healed them, they couldn't recognize the healing. There's a lot of folk that go to church every Sunday after Sunday. Most of them new, but still walk around with their head down. You better lift your hand to the hills, which comes your help, and your help comes from God. Because when you fix your eyes on Jesus, you can see some stuff that you never saw before. You can do some things that you've never done before. When you look around and see how God is blessing you, you can show thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Jesus could have complained about blind folk. He could have been complaining about lame folk. But he had a mission that he had to accomplish. And his accomplished mission was to go to the cross. Even when he got up on the cross, he said, Father, why have you forsaken me? But he didn't step off the cross. He suffered, bled, and died for your healing. He suffered, bled, and died not just for your physical stuff, and we good for physical healing. He suffered, bled, and died for your mental healing as well. He suffered, bled, and died for your spiritual healing. And here it is now. We got nerve to complain about what we ain't got. But as long as you got King Jesus, we don't need nothing else. As long as you got Jesus, because he bled, died, but that's not the end of the story. He got up on the I've been changed by the power of Jesus. I've been changed by the goodness of the Lord. I might not have everything I want, but I ain't who I used to be. But the old man Houston is dead and gone. I am a new creature in Jesus Christ. Every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. I get up with a brand new cup of goodness and mercy every single day. And because I got some goodness and I got some mercy, I can make it. All hell been breaking loose around in your household. But you can look to the hills. You can look to the power and call it down for yourself. If you need a healing, you ain't got to call the pastor all the time. God gave it to you. Pray for yourself. And after you pray for yourself, you ain't feel, call your deacons. Then call the pastor. And all of us going to put all our power together.
Yes, sir.
Because we're not in this alone. Out of 10, it was only one that looked. It was only one that opened their eyes. You can't get mad at the other folk for not opening their eyes. You can't get mad at other people for not walking how you walk. You can't get mad at other people for not praising how you pray. You can't get upset with other folk. Because God has done something for all y'all.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
But you have the responsibility to be the one.
Yes, sir.
He said, go. Because your faith has made you whole.
Yes, sir.
Can you give God thanks for the faith he's already given?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Is there one here today? Let us stand. Let us stand. Is there one here today that's ready to receive Jesus and the power of salvation? Is there one here today that want to be one with Christ? We offer Christ to you today.